everybody, and welcome to episode 44 of the Rich and Heidi Wedding Show. It's a very special number. I love numerology and double digits, and I am 44.
Yeah, so that's an awesome episode number.
Yes, luckily we can go and buy champagne or...
No, you obviously didn't watch TV last night.
What?
The latest level 3 regulations.
What is that?
No more alcohol. No more champagne.
Okay, but luckily, I've got a bottle of red wine gifted by a very dear friend, and I will celebrate the fact that we are on episode 44.
A teaspoon a night.
Teaspoon a night. Something like that.
Okay, well, it's obviously been an eventful week, and we're not going to dig into all the level 3 regulations and things, but... Something else that happened last week was the 4th annual networking conference.
Yeah.
And I was very privileged to be one of the speakers.
I'm very proud of it.
So it's a conference that's actually aimed at the wedding industry. But it's also aimed at small business owners, specifically more your creative small businesses, as well as business startups. So obviously, you know, we're talking about this after the fact. So if you missed the conference... Luckily, they've got a what they call the networking conference rewind. Yeah. And I'm going to put the link for the website down below in the description. And you can go onto the website up to the 31st of July, buy your ticket, if I'm correct, less than 200 Rand. And you can watch all 20 talks from speakers from around the world with some serious motivation on how to keep your business running in these challenging times, as well as how to restart. And I think that was the theme of the whole conference. So how to restart the wedding industry and our business, you know, coming out of lockdown slowly but surely. It is going slow, but we are heading in the right direction.
Yeah, but any business can benefit from it. And if you take the ticket price, it's actually so low for an investment in your business.
Yeah.
Cheaper than a bottle of wine.
And you're going to be saving money now, yeah. You can't buy alcohol, so you can buy a ticket to the rewind of a networking conference. But yeah, let's get back to today.
Okay.
So back in episode 32, we discussed boudoir photography or boudoir. I'm not always exactly sure how to pronounce it.
Just say it so that it sounds sexy.
Okay, no, yeah, then you'll need to do it.
Boudoir.
Okay. We discussed the various types of sessions. And we also realized that our original behind-the-scenes video was like 10 years old.
10 years ago, yeah.
I think for anyone in the creative industry, we all aim to grow. And we grow our talents, I believe. We grow our skills. And often when you look at something that you've done like 10 years ago, you think, what was I thinking?
It's a long time ago.
It's a long time. So
we're obviously still proud of it. But yes, many things have changed. And
So we just thought it's maybe a good idea to shoot a new behind-the-scenes session. And we've realized over the years that there's a lot of girls who are very keen to do such a session, but they are, I don't want to use the word afraid, but they're unsure of how such a session will work, what happens behind the scenes. And that was our whole aim. So that was the one thing that happened. And another thing that happened is we received feedback or a testimonial from a recent client. And I really think it's worthwhile if we read it. I unfortunately don't know it by heart, but it basically says, I just want to thank you very much for today. You are amazing. I cannot describe how comfortable I felt during the shoot. This is a shoot that I never even thought in my wildest dreams I would do, but you both made me feel so comfortable. I will do it again anytime. You gave me that confidence boost. Really, it was great. I'm so glad we have you as our photographers for the rest of our lives. You are just great. Thank you. So
we're also doing their wedding later this year.
But I think what's amazing from that is the fact that she touches on it, that it's a shoot that she said she thought she would never do. And for me, that whole thing about the fact that she clearly states that it gave her a confidence boost.
Yes.
And like we said, and I don't want to repeat what we said in episode 32, but the whole thing was that you often end up booking the shoot for your partner, but it ends up being a shoot for yourself.
Totally. I mean, even the first time when we did the shoot of this client that we whose testimonial we just read, when Richard showed her on camera
some of the first images.
One of the first images, her reaction was, I look like a FHM model. I mean, you know what, if you can give a girl that confidence, it's actually just through the camera. It wasn't edited. It was a testimony of how she looked at that moment. Just to see it on the camera, I mean, that was priceless.
So, we unfortunately cannot show you the full behind-the-scenes video tonight. We only shot it this morning. But we thought we would leave you with Mia's feedback after the shoot. We had a quick little interview with her just after the session. And we'll give you a glimpse into what happened. And you will need to stay tuned and give us a few days to properly edit it. And it will be one of our future episodes.
Definitely.
Okay, so let's have a listen to what Mia had to say.
How was it?
It was an amazing experience. I'm going to be honest, I didn't know what to expect. I was a bit nervous because, you know, body image and posing in front of the camera in underwear, lingerie. But it was such an amazing experience with you two because you make us feel very confident. And even when you show the photos that you're taking during the shoot, it helps a lot because you feel like, wow, that's really me. I can't believe that, you know, it's beautiful. And it's really uplifting and it makes you feel good about yourself.
Okay, well, that's awesome.
It was amazing.
I think that's probably the one positive thing.
Yeah, that we also would like to convey is, I think any girl can photograph beautifully. With a boudoir shoot or a celebration shoot, whatever you call it.
Yeah.
It's more about celebrating your body.
Yes.
Than anything else.
Yeah, and we just put on Facebook last week the, what do you call it, testimonial we received from the one girl.
Oh, yes.
You know, a few weeks ago. And it's amazing that everyone says the same thing, that it's absolutely, it gives you a self-esteem boost.
It does. Yeah. It really does.
So would you recommend it?
I would 110% recommend this shoot. Not only for your partner, but yourself as well. Because it just makes you feel, I am beautiful and I don't look bad, you know. It's like, it's just very uplifting and I would definitely recommend it for anyone.
Yeah. We often say with a shoot like this, it is important to, for once, sit back and think how your partner sees you.
Yes.
To try to see yourself out of your partner's eyes.
Yes.
Yeah.
And that person loves you just the way you are. Yes. And we are often so critical of our body.
Yeah.
A body that serves us every day.
Yeah.
No matter what and no matter how we
treat it.
We treat it.
Yeah.
And we actually have to celebrate our bodies. It is. I'm not one for shaming a body so we must celebrate the fact
definitely.
That we are healthy.
Definitely. And also a tip just to stretch before the time.
So it is like a bit of a workout.
It's a workout, out and out.
Stretch. Yeah. Tip one, stretch beforehand.
Yeah.
Stretch and wax.
Oh, that's awesome. We'll remember that.
Stretch, wax, and exfoliate.
Well, thank you guys.
Okay.
Thank you very much. We appreciate your time so much. You're always willing to help us out with shoots, and we really do appreciate it.
Thank you guys. I appreciate you.
I hope that gives you an indication of how comfortable she was and how awesome the experience for her was. Make sure to follow the episodes because we are going to show a behind the scenes of the video and of the making of this entire shoot. So make sure to subscribe so that the notifications is on and that you don't miss out.
And remember, when we get to 1,000 subscribers, we'll also be giving away that Rich and Adi family lifestyle or couple shoot at the value of 3,000 Rand, as well as the nomination bracelet and link, kindly sponsored by Gabriel Jewelers in the Fountains Mall. And all you have to do is be subscribed. So thank you all for watching. Stay tuned. We've got some exciting episodes coming up this week. With some great advice and some great venues. I think it's going to be a nice, versatile group of episodes
very
this week.
Versatile this
definitely.
Week.
So make sure you don't miss an episode, and we see you guys again tomorrow night.
And if there is something you want us to talk about,
or if you want us to feature your venue or your business, send us an email.
Please let us know.
Please.
Bye for now.
Cheers.